हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम हेयर अगेन विद द पार्ट नंबर 4 ऑफ द वीडियो ऑफ दिस वेरी चैप्टर 3 ह्यूमन रिप्रोडक्शन. एंड इन दिस वेरी पार्ट ऑफ माय वीडियो आई विल बी डीलिंग विद द टॉपिक गैमेटोजेनेसिस. सो स्टार्टिंग, व्हाट इज गैमेटोजेनेसिस? सो गैमेटोजेनेसिस इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द गैमेट इज रिफर्स टू एज गैमेटोजेनेसिस एज इट इज बीइंग मेड ऑफ द टू वर्ड्स. दिस इज द टू वर्ड्स गैमीट. Wait a minute. This is a gamete made of the two words, which is gamete and genesis. Genesis, I have already told you several times, this is known as the formation. And gamete, this gameto is here the term used for the gamete. So the formation of gamete is known as gametogenesis. Now the formation of the male sperm cells and the female ovum. These are the two gametes produced by the male reproductive and female reproductive systems. So the formation of these gametes is termed to be as the gametogenesis. Okay, collectively gametogenesis. Okay, in this process, what happens? There is a continuous reduction of the number of the chromosomes from the diploid to the haploid, and that haploid number will lead to the formation of your gamete cells, mature germ cell, and that gamete or mature germ cell will be responsible for undergoing the fertilization. Gametogenesis, the resultant of that gametogenesis is the sperm cells, and those sperm cells actually have the structure which is shown here. This is shown here. This has a rounded primary germ. This is a large primary germ cells which is having a structure which is comprised of the head region, and this is a mature germ cell consist of the neck, and this is the tail. So this region is formed because of the equal division of the cytoplasm during the process of the sperm formation. The cytoplasmic contents, the most of the cytoplasmic contents are lost, and whatever the contents are lost are equally distributed among all those sperms. Means all those sperms, how much sperms are formed, all the division of the cytoplasmic contents will be equal in all those sperms. So if have to divide equally, there must be some structure like this so that they have some kind of motility to move towards the ovum. Now if we talk about the female germ cells, the female germ cells generally are larger in size, and so because of the unequal division of the cytoplasm, they becomes increasingly large. They become somewhat more larger, and because of that large, there's the unequal cytoplasmic divisions, and because of this unequal cytoplasmic division, they do not have any kind of motility. So sperm has to come and fertilize with the ovum. So this is I have talked about the mature sperm cells, which is produced by the male reproductive system, and this is about the female reproductive system. Okay, so this is about gametogenesis of the gamete of the male and the female gamete. Now moving towards the formation of the sperms. So the formation of the sperms is termed to be as spermatogenesis. Where it takes place? It takes place in the seminiferous tubules. You have to remember this thing. This is very important. This is very important. You have to remember that the formation of the sperms takes place inside the seminiferous tubules, and that will result into the formation of the spore sperms. Okay, so how these spore sperms comes? There are several processes taking place that will lead to the formation, conclude into the formation of the four sperms. Okay, so maturation of the sperms takes place in the epididymis, and from there it gains motility after they have been produced by the seminiferous tubules. Four sperm cells, they will undergo or will be stored inside the epididymis. You have known about epididymis, the storage of the sperm cells, means sperm ko store karne ka kaam it karta hai, and providing motility will be also provided by the epididymis. Okay, now, and this process of spermatogenesis is constantly taking place after puberty till the death, but there is a difference in this phase. This spermatogenesis continuously takes place after puberty till death, but in the female, if I talk about, then oogenesis begins actually from before the birth, you can say that. Okay, the fate of the ovum is decided before birth, and after till they will produce ovum till the menopause takes place. Okay, at the age of 45 to 50 years near about. about. Okay, so that is not a continuous process taking place till death, but spermatogenesis is a continuous process that will take place till the death. So this is a major difference. Now let me show you some the steps involved in the spermatogenesis. Okay, so the steps involved in the spermatogenesis is like this. The very first step is the primordial germ cells in embryo. The primordial germ cells in embryo, here the will be the male sperm cells or male germ, male gametic cells, or you can call male sperm cells or male germ cells you call, or the second is the what? The second is the Sertoli cells. So we'll have to take that formation of the sperm. So we'll talking about the male germ cells. Okay, so that male germ cells are have spermatogonia. Okay, that spermatogonia, this primordial germ cells in embryo, will contain several spermatogonia. There will be several spermatogonia present on it. These spermatogonial cells will undergo mitotic division. Mitotic divisions, first of all, they will be what will be the ploidy, they will be diploid right now. And in mitotic divisions, there the number of the cells remains the same. Equational division. So the spermatogonial cells will undergo several mitotic divisions, and after going several mitotic divisions, they will what do? They will form a primary spermatocyte, and that primary spermatocyte is the spermatogonium. This is primary spermatocyte. This spermatogonium will here. This is the step. Wait a minute. Okay. after the spermatogonial cells undergoing few mitotic divisions, they will lead to the formation of the spermatogonium. And this spermatogonium is actually the mature or differentiated cells. Means which have mature cell or mature spermatogonial cells have a dense cytoplasmic content. Okay, they will have a dense cytoplasmic content. And now these spermatogonial cells, which is right now also diploid in number, 2n in number, will now undergo mitotic division. This mature cell will now differentiate into another primary spermatocyte. Okay, first mitotic division, this is the first, second, third, just several mitotic division, this will lead to the formation of primary spermatocyte. And right now this primary spermatocyte is what? 2n in number. Got it? These primary spermatocytes are actually somewhat growed. This is somewhat bigger structure than this structure. Okay, this is a mature, but this will later on become somewhat more differentiated into a bigger structure, which is known as primary spermatocytes. But the ploidy will be same, okay, because it is undergoing mitotic division only. Now what happens? There begins a meiosis first. Okay, now these primary spermatocytes will undergo meiotic division, and you know that this meiotic division is called as what? What it is called as? It is called as reductional division. So the number of the cells present here, which is diploid, from the 2n, it will reduce into n and n. Okay, so it will produce two secondary spermatocytes. Okay, now at the end of the secondary spermatocytes, again meiosis 2 will takes place, and that each of these cells will produce again two cells, and four cells are formed all total, which is termed to be as early spermatids. Okay, these early spermatids, these are called to as early spermatid. And this process of conversion of spermatids into sperms is known as spermiogenesis. Okay, this is known as spermiogenesis. And these early spermatids will get some nourishment from the Sertoli cells of the primary germ, these primary germ cells, which have the male gamete cell as along with that it has Sertoli cells, that will provide it the nutrition. And these early spermatids will now convert into a structure known as sperm cells, and these distribution will be the cytoplasmic distribution in each of four the sperm cells will be equal. Okay, so these are the steps taking place. Okay, these steps are taking place. This steps is known as the very step is the very first here is known as the multiplication phase. Three phases are there. This is a multiplication phase, and other here, from here to here, is the growth phase, and from here to here is the maturation phase. Okay, this is maturation phase. So three phases are there in all total of the spermatogenesis: multiplication phase, growth phase, and the maturation phase. Okay, maturation phase is the conversion of the early spermatids into the sperm cells, and this process is known as spermiogenesis. So let's read some points written over here of spermatogenesis. The very first point is the production of the sperms occurs in the testis in the seminiferous tubules. The first stage of the spermatogenesis, mitotic cell division of the primordial germ cells to produce spermatogonial cells. Now these spermatogonial cells will further undergo a period of growth to form primary spermatocytes. Okay, you have seen here, each primary spermatocytes will then undergo two mitotic division. The first mitotic division will lead to the formation of the secondary spermatocytes. Second meiotic division will produce the four spermatids. These spermatid cells will then undergo differentiation to form sperm cells, and these sperm cells are nourished by Sertoli cells, and each primary spermatocytes produce four sperm cells which have haploid number of chromosomes, that is 23. So this was all about, you have learned about the spermatogenesis. Now let's see the typical structure of the sperms, how the cytoplasmic contents are equally divided into such a structure. Okay, let me tell you here, this is a somewhat more defined and easier way to tell you about spermatogenesis. See here. Here you can see the chromosome number has been written, how the chromosomal number are being reduced, type of germ cells involved in the process, and the type of the division that each cells are undergoing. So very first phase is known as the multiplication phase. I have told you there. In this phase, there is the 46 chromosome number, means diploid. The spermatogonial cells, type of a germ cell is what? Spermatogonial cells. This spermatogonial cell is diploid in number. It will undergo mitosis and will lead to the formation of the spermatogonia. Now these spermatogonia will later on will get somewhat grow, will grow in size and will form the primary spermatocyte. Okay, this is right now also what, 2n in number. Ploidy has not been changed up to here. Now these primary spermatocytes has to undergo two mitotic division, first and second. The first mitotic division will lead to the formation of two secondary spermatocytes. Now the ploidy has changed. Now the ploidy has n, means the reductional division has start taking place. After these, each of these secondary spermatocytes will later form the two cells. This is the formation of the spermato meiosis first completion. When we start meiosis 2, so each of the secondary spermatocytes, means this and this, will produce two spermatids. Okay, two cells each, so total four. These total four cells are termed to be as spermatids. Now there has to be a structure that have some kind of motility, so that has to take place by the process known as spermiogenesis. That spermiogenesis means conversion of the spermatids into a spermatozoa, means sperm like structure. So the cytoplasmic contents have to be divided into the three regions: head, neck, and tail region. Okay, this is head region, this is neck, and this is a tail region. Got it? So this is our typical spermatogenesis taking place. And moving towards the slide, a typical structure of a sperm. A sperm is a microscopic motile structure which is composed of a head, neck, and a middle piece and a tail. Here you can see, this is an head region, this is a neck region, in which this middle piece region, you can call it neck region, and this, there is a middle piece comprising of the mitochondria that provides the energy source for the swimming, as they have to swim along. So they have some kind of energy from that, they get these energies from the mitochondria. The sperm head contains an elongated haploid nucleus, and the anterior portion is covered a cap-like structure called as acrosomal structure. This is an acrosomal structure, and the nucleus containing the chromosome, the nucleus is somewhat elongated. Okay, remember, the nucleus is elongated. द मिडल पेज कंटेन्स माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया प्रोड्यूस एनर्जी फॉर द स्पर्म मोटिलिटी फॉर द फर्टिलाइजेशन आई हैव टोल्ड यू टेल विल हेल्प इट टू स्विम एंड रीच टूवर्ड्स द एक्सेल फॉर द फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड द सेमिनल प्लाज्मा विल ऑल्सो बी रिलीज अलॉन्ग विद द स्पर्म्स एंड द टोटल कंटेंट ऑफ द स्पर्म इज 40% and 60% is seminal fluid. So this is all about the spermatogenesis and the structure of the sperms I have talked about in this video. In the later video, I'll be talking about the formation of the ova, and that is we'll talking about the oogenesis.